Bare lids on the shirt.
What are you on about? We're live.
We're live.
Big man sing here. Welcome to the Friday night rant, bruv. You're now locked in, bruv. Myself, Castillo in.
The boy gang.
Big man sing. Yeah. Do your thing, bruv. Do your promo, bruv.
Listen. England. I'm joking about that. Listen. Zaza Potion, you don't know already. Yeah, follow it on all socials. ZAZAPOTION. Yeah, Snapchat, Instagram. We ship all over England, even Scotland and Wales. And where else?
Big man ting. Czechoslovakia, bruv.
Oh, that's right, what it is. That's our new country. Bruv.
Big man
ting. That's our new country.
You get me? Real talk, yeah. Carry on. You got more, bruv. You got more. What else you want to tell them? How, what liters can they get? What sizes?
Oh, yeah. See, you're doing better than me.
Bruv, it's your thing, bruv.
Freaking £15 a litre. Boom. Yeah, this is a litre. This is £15. Yeah, we sell it by the litre.
£15, bruv, not pesos, bruv.
Yeah, if you want non-alcoholic litres, it's £10.
£10 for you soggy utes, bruv.
You understand the
thing.
And the merch is coming. Look, Zaza Potion, Zaza Potion. £20 a t-shirt, £20 a hat.
There you go, bruv.
You get me?
Big man sing, yeah, make sure you go stream Sniper, bruv. It's hit 50K, bruv. 50K already, bruv, you get me? It's only been a month. Hit 50K on the sniper thing, bruv. So I got another official music video coming out soon because the last one got shadow banned, bruv. Dropping in like 2 weeks, bruv. Because now it's at 50K. I made a little bet. I said, if this is 50K before the end of June, I'm going to do another official thing that don't get banned, bruv. So look out for that, bruv. You get me? And follow my YouTube channel. Got bad advice about the gallon, bruv. So man them, you ain't getting no pussy, bruv. Make sure you check that out, bruv. Get me? Make sure your summer's good, bruv. You get me? Because some of you managers at home, not getting pussy, bruv. Going bald. That's a mad life to live, bruv. You get me? So make sure, bruv. Make sure you go stream Sniper and get some pussy, bruv. Yeah, big man ting. Yeah? So, bruv, how's your week been, bruv?
The week's been wet. It's been raining and shit now, innit?
Yeah, bruv. I got to say something, though, bruv. You look good today, bruv.
Oh, you say
you look good. You got the shave. Nah, you look good, bruv.
I look a bit younger. Bad guy. This
the shape up, bruv. The shape up is amazing, bruv. That's immaculate. Shout out to Barber, bruv. Don't be a pagan. Shout out to Barber.
Nah,
that's a good shape.
I'm not shouting out no Barber.
You're sick, bruv. The man did a good
job. All-star Barbers, my guy.
What's your guy, though? Your dread, bruv. You didn't want to shout him out.
Nah, I'm not shouting out his name.
Why? You don't want to give him no customers?
No. Go to All Star Barbers.
See what I'm saying, bruv? You see what Jay Gang did? He went and watched RuPaul's Drag Race, bruv. Patting up his life, bruv. You get me? He went to a Beauty Base, got the lemon and an almond scrub, bruv. You get me? From Beauty Base. You get me? That papaya, bruv. You get me? Scrub the face. That's why his skin's looking immaculate, bruv. That's what you man need to do. Because you're not out here, bruv. You ain't going to the right barbers, bruv. Going to a guy that gives you fucking shaving bumps, bruv. Your neck's looking like a Snickers bar. You're looking fucking bad out here, bruv. You get me? Go to Jay Gang's guy or go to my guy Justice, bruv, in North London, bruv. Go to AD if you're in Birmingham. Cash if you're in Birmingham. You get me, bruv. Go to them man there, bruv. So there you go. That's my shout out right there.
100.
Big man ting. Bruv, like literally, I'm looking at the topics, bruv. We need a...
How's your week been, though?
My week's been blessed. I just been on the gym ting, bruv. I just been on the gym ting hard, bruv.
Hard? Like how often do you go to the
gym? I go gym every single day, bruv. I go every day. I only rest when my body can't do it.
What do you do in the gym, though?
Everything. Full body workouts every day.
Do you go on the treadmill and running?
No. I'm not trying to lose weight, bruv.
Oh, you're trying to like.
I'm just trying to get bigger, bruv. You get me? Okay. Like, what's it? The people want to know. Yeah, they need a video from you of your routine, bruv. Your grooming routine, bruv.
My grooming
routine. Yeah, because your skin's looking immaculate right now, my guy.
They need a routine.
Yeah, to know what you're doing, bruv.
Nah, man, you can show.
Are you using argan? Are you using the argan oils? I believe you're using the argan oils, bruv.
Castor oil.
Done. See, there you go, bruv. This guy, you know about the thing, bruv. See, this guy, he looks after himself.
Castor,
he looks after
good things.
Big man thing. See that there, bruv. See? J-Gang hair care routine coming soon, bruv. He's got that Garnier Fructis thing,
bruv.
Nah, man,
I leave that to you. You do the I'm surprised you ain't got friggin' ain't sponsored you yet.
Bruv, I'm trying, bruv. I'm trying to get this money, bruv. Because being popular with no peas is dead, bruv. You get me? That's shit. Yeah? Bruv, big man thing. So we got England and Scotland, bruv. Who you think's going to win?
Scotty.
Scotland, you want that? That's because you want them to win. You don't think they're gonna win. You just want them to win because you're like,
I don't even know one person on the Scottish side, but I feel like
they should win.
I feel like they've got it in the bag, man. I don't know why.
Do you know what? Yeah, I feel like I'm gonna say England to win in it because I don't know
why. Because you're from England,
yeah. Do you know what I mean? So I might as well, bruv. You get me? You got to root for the people, then, bruv. But like, shout out to Scotland as well, bruv. You get me? I like the Scottish accent, bruv.
You know, I want the Scotland to win because. Quite a few people from Scotland have bought Zaza Potion, so I'm rooting for them.
Oh, there you go, bruv. There you go, bruv. You know,
like the Scottish people, Scotland and Wales, man.
You know, Scotland has bare crackheads, bruv.
Yeah.
Like, and bare stabbings, crackheads and stabbings. They used to be the, I think they're like number one in the stabbings of the world at one point.
Oh, what, in Scotland?
In Europe, they was just stabbing people in a madness, bruv. Mm. Like, it's actually serious, like, Scottish people are serious people for real, bruv. They're like different.
Oh, I believe you. Still, Scotland, yeah, man. Do you know what? They've been supporting, man.
Say that again?
They've been supporting.
Thanks, so. Big man thing. So shout out to them. Bruv, you know, like, they got... I heard this news today. I was vexed, bruv. Carnival's been cancelled, bruv.
Yo, piss. No vest and tracksuit.
Bruv, you, I was going gym just for this day, bruv. This is mad.
I knew that was... You kind of knew that was going to happen, though.
No, nah, of course, bruv. Of course.
You know, like, Boris is unbalanced, man.
Bruv, you know, they say they're going to do another full lockdown, I'm hearing, in September.
So they're just teasing us.
Yeah. So we get a little freedom for the summer and then we just get locked back down in September, bruv.
So I was telling my friend today, because my friend shouted me about some business, like proper business, like legitimate business,
yeah,
like opening certain things and that. And I said, there's no, it's too up and down right now.
Yeah. Like, there's no not, point. There's no
you're
point
not
in
balanced,
doing shit,
you get me? We don't feel balanced. Like everything's like, we don't know what's going to happen. Like, you know, like when things are normal, you can kind of say, all right.
Yeah,
like,
facts,
you
facts.
You know what I'm trying to say?
But now you can't plan anything.
You can't plan anything, man.
I was planning a big man thing show, bruv. I've been planning that since, like, I had two sold out ones before.
Yeah.
And I was planning one in lockdown, couldn't do it. And now I haven't even bothered planning a new
there's
one.
There's no point. You're going to have to refund.
Yeah, just have to refund people their piece, bruv. That's just a mad thing, bruv. You get me? So I just thought, fuck that. Yeah, did you get me? I just thought I might as well just allow it. But they're saying, like, they're going to do some online carnival thing, bruv.
Oh, fuck.
That's what shit, innit? I hate, bruv, I'm not going to lie. I hate everything. Dumb. I hate everything live. And I hate, not live like that. I hate everything concert lives. Like, the Versus thing is bliss. Yeah, but I hate so, anything, like, I don't want to watch carnival live on a stream, bruv. Why?
What's, so they're going to, like, film floats and you're in your house?
Nah, it's like, the last year they had, like, instruments. Like, I mean, people playing, like, instruments, people dancing, artists performing and shit. They did that last year on TV.
Our last year carnival.
Yeah, because there was no carnival. So do you know how shit that is, bruv? Just watching. They just had a few artists performing, bruv. It's like, this is shit, bruv.
Yeah, no, I'm not with it, man.
Do you know what I mean? Like, they had, like, I think they had, like, people performing grime and shit for, like, on the corner. I was like, what the fuck is this shit, bruv? I don't want to see that. That's so not carnival-y, bruv.
Do you reckon, like, next year we'll be back to normal?
No, bruv. I get the feeling.
So that means we're actually fucked.
Yeah, I think
we're
so.
We're just finished then. Because
I believe, like, I'm literally contemplating immigrating to the Philippines, bruv.
Yeah, like cutting from it, innit?
Yeah, bruv. Just go to the Philippines, bruv. Go to Thailand, bruv.
Because there's people in them third world countries and they're just living normal.
That's a fact.
Yeah, and remember,
they don't worry about strains, bruv. They worry about food, bruv. That's what they're worried about. Food and money, bruv. That's what they're thinking about. They ain't worried about no COVID, bruv. Because, like, you see in this country, bruv, I feel like they just keep on changing up the thing, bruv. Soon they're going to have the Czechoslovakian Daglistan variant, bruv. You're like, yo, where's the people coming from giving us this, bruv?
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Every year, bruv, like, they're just adding new things. They did it with wireless as well, bruv. Wireless, they did, like, a live thing as well, bruv. I don't want to see that shit, bruv. What's our big man thing? The people are telling us to watch something, bruv. Let's see what's going on. Let's see what's going on the phones, bruv. Big man thing. So what am I seeing? I'm watching a video right now. Let me see. Oh, no.
Let me see.
Love it. Nah, bruv. That's not what I want to see in my day, bruv. This is your kind of thing, though, Jay, man. I think you should put this on your channel, bruv. This is your kind of thing, bruv. It's your kind of thing, Jay.
this is what I'm saying. These men are over there. I don't know what they're on, man. But big up the Martians, innit? you know?
That is funny as fuck, bruv. My God. Yeah, bruv. Do you know what, yeah? Are you not going to show the videos, bruv, about the grenades? Big man thing, yeah? This is the maddest clip we're going to play you lot, yeah? Bruv. This is a mad thing. Are you not playing that shit? Watch this shit, bruv. This is a mad thing.
When they play it, they can see it on the live and that?
Yeah.
Okay. Crazy.
Bruv, this is disturbing. So basically, a man pulls out a grenade, bruv, in the middle of an argument, bruv. A grenade, bruv. Is it on?
Not even a knife. A grenade.
Is it playing, yeah? Bruv, you watched that one, innit?
I watched it.
Tell me when it's done. That's a mad thing. You lot see it, yeah? Bruv, you lot watching, yeah? The man, is that the one where the man's arguing with the girl? Oh, no, is that the one where the man's getting pushed? Bruv, a man had a fucking grenade, bruv. A grenade. You saw that video, innit?
Yeah, what country do you think that's in?
Bruv, I don't know what...
That's not England. That must be in Russia,
bruv,
or something.
I don't know what country where you can just casually buy a grenade, bruv. And wherever that is, I need to know so I never go there in my life, bruv. A grenade. You know how mad that is? Where? That's some GTA shit to have a grenade.
Mm.
Do you know what I mean?
Mad still.
If you could buy a grenade, would you buy one?
No way. The fuck am I buying
a grenade? If the shops were selling grenades and you had ops, would you buy a grenade?
No way.
Never. They need to pray that shit never fucking... Like, they need to make sure they never bring that to the UK, bruv. The youths will be buying grenades up like cakes, bruv.
I heard that people got like bare people got injured when it went off and that. There was the next clip here when there was a man in a car.
He was playing a grenade and he dropped that shit in the car.
Yeah.
What could you do in that split second though?
You just have to run. You can't, remember it goes off in 5 seconds, you know.
How far can you get in 5 seconds though?
How far did they get? They got out of the car and got, they didn't get hurt.
Bruv, do you not be vexed if you had your seatbelt on?
Oh, you're dead. There's no way your brain's going to make you click undone your seatbelt and open the door in 5 seconds.
That is, I don't even know what I'd do, bruv. There's another video as well. We're going to play that, yeah? It's a man in a restaurant, bruv. Yeah? Because a girl wouldn't give him the number. You're not playing that, yeah? This one is the maddest thing I've seen online, bruv. This is mad.
Yeah, that's crazy, man.
This is mad, bruv. I can't, that's a mad thing. They're about to play it, bruv. Big man thing. You lot, look at this shit, bruv. Yeah, this is a mad thing. Playing.
That man was moving mad.
Bruv. Oh my God.
Oh my God!
Hey. Mad. Go.
What is
your
fuck?
This is mad.
Bro, go on.
Yeah, what you talking about?
You're embarrassing yourself.
I'm embarrassing you, bitch.
You are embarrassing
me. Who is you? Who is you? Who is you?
Nobody to you.
Who is my bitch?
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Go. What the fuck?
Big man thing, yeah. You know the maddest thing about that, yeah? There's a lot of men like that, you know?
100%.
When a gal turns them down, bruv, they move mad.
Move mad.
But in America, like, bruv, do you know when you think about things like mad scenarios in your head, that sounds made up. If you told somebody that happened, nobody would ever believe you.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. Remember, there's different types of men, you know? There's men that can't take rejection, yeah? They're slash rapey.
Facts.
You get what I'm trying to say? So there's men that will be like, bro, welcome, babes. And the girl will be like, nah. And they'll be like, what do you mean, nah?
Oh my
like,
God.
They're sick. Yeah.
They'll be like, your butt is anyway, and then start switching. Like yeah, facts.
And there's man that will say, right, your butt is anyway, and then just tell you to fuck off.
Facts.
There's man that will be like, what? You're rejecting me, like running you down and moving mad. You
facts.
Get me? Him, he backed his machine and beat corn. Like, what are you doing?
Bruv, do you know what the maddest thing about that is, yeah? Like, literally, you know when you said about the three types of man, yeah? Imagine this, back in the day, I knew some guy, brother. One time I was in Shepherd's Bush walking around. I knew him through someone I knew and was all walking, yeah? And my guy was moving to every single gal on road, like every single gal on the road,
problems,
yeah?
Man.
And then here's the maddest thing, yeah? Like 2 years later, somebody sent me like some article, yeah? And it was, he was in an article because he like date raped some gal in a, on one of them weekender things. I was like, yo.
Yeah.
And apparently like he woke up on her talking about, yeah, like round two, yeah?
What?
Mad thing.
This is what I'm saying, bro.
Bruv, there's a lot of rapey men out here, bruv. It's actually mad.
And it's mad because you done that to the girl. The girl wasn't really even being rude to you or nothing like that. She just allow her, bro. Let her live her movie. You get what I'm trying to say?
Bruv.
You're getting mad talking about, who are you, nigga?
Bruv, somebody in the comments wrote, that's what Castillo meant by sniper, bruv. That's dread. Nah, sniper got to his head. Nah, that's a legit real life sniper for real, bruv. Big man thing. Bare people saying he listens to sniper. That's true. Fucking up. But you know the maddest thing is, yeah, I know a lot of men like that as well, that literally they can't take a girl shutting them down. It's like the rejection thing is different. That's why I personally feel, yeah, like a lot of men, like you should just chat to girl and just get used to rejection, bruv. Because literally, that's just the way the world works, bruv. Like you're going
to
be getting...
Not everyone's going to say yes to you. If you're like that, you've got serious problems. Do you get
that's
what
I'm saying. That's why it's
but
fucked,
remember
bruv.
The youth, remember the youth that phoned like about a month ago and he was talking about, if a girl says no to me, Rare.
If I
call her around, she knows what time it is.
Yeah,
she
facts.
He asked her to do the thing. And, if she
and you're
don't,
saying she knows she's wasting his time, innit?
She don't, I'm going to call a girl in front of her.
Yeah, that's mad. Man
and
was making
tell her to get the fuck out the yard, innit?
Bruv, man was on some delusional thing,
yeah,
bruv.
But that's what I'm saying. But that's his truth. But why are you like that, big man?
Bruv, do you know what the maddest thing? Yeah, that's some real delusions right there. Do you know what the maddest thing is, yeah? Like, I don't know. Like, you see certain men, like, I remember back in the day, there's certain men, like, you'd see them, and if you're on a rave or whatever, they'd be grabbing things by the arm and all that stuff. I think that's a mad thing, bruv. All of that there, bruv. Even grabbing a thing at a rave is mad. Like, you know, back in the day, it was a casual thing. Nobody really think much of it. But when you kind of deep it, bruv, it's actually kind of like rapey, bruv. I would never grab up a random thing at a rave.
Like, grab her, like...
Back of her arm, like, yo, come, come.
Like, it depends how you grab her, though. Because there's grabbing her, like, in a way, like, well, come here. Like, or there's, like...
Even, do you know what? Even all of that is mad, because I'll be honest with you, I don't even like when people randomly come and tap me on the shoulder, bro. Just give me like, nah, like, do you know what I'm saying? It's just a weird feeling, innit? Do you know what I'm trying to say? Yeah. Like, with me, my thing is this year, these days, you can get cancelled and accused of so many mad things. These days, you just got to move carefully, bro. Yeah. You get me? You got to move carefully. That's why that guy that called that time is a fucking weirdo, bro. He's a bit mad, yeah? Like, here's another thing that we're going to play for you, yeah? A man robs a pregnant woman and her baby, bro, in Manchester. Mad thing. Look at this shit. You gonna play that one, yeah? This thing is mad. Look at this one, you lot. This is fucked up. Look at that shit, bruv. That is a mad thing. They literally, bruv, you know what? Them things that at first, I thought that was fake. Mm. I thought, nah, they planned that shit because that is bizarre, bruv.
It's weird still.
Do you know the thing is, how much, like, you see them man there, if they got caught, how many years in jail do people get for shit like that?
That's
a light thing, innit?
Yeah, that's light, man.
That's like a year or so.
Yeah, it's not, yeah, remember they didn't harm the woman.
Mm.
They just basically told her to get out of the car. Grand Theft Auto.
How long is that usually?
Probably like they'll probably get like a year and a half.
Fuck, like, but they won't. But do half in it.
Mm,
you know, with things like that, if you get on your record, can you travel out?
Well, in certain places they won't allow you because you got a criminal record. Now.
So if you got a criminal record at all, you can't go. Fuck, like depending on what.
It depends on where it is, but stuff like that, certain countries will be like, "Big man, fuck you going with that? You trying to steal cars over here?" Do you get what I'm trying to say? So
Do you know there's a new thing with a child support thing where if people don't pay their like their CSA payments, bruv, they're thinking about confiscating people's passports.
I heard something like that.
What do you think of that?
Yeah.
This guy's a joker, bruv. You know what? You're one of them guys here. You're one of them iron fist type dudes. Like you like discipline and order. Like you're one of the maximum penalty, fuck it kind of thing.
Nah, not maximum penalty for everything, but certain things. You know what I mean? Like rapists and that. They should be getting and paedophiles and certain things.
Do you ever watch Louis Theroux?
No.
Do you ever see it? It's a documentary. It's like a UK documentary guy, yeah. He did a thing, yeah.
There's one called he's got glasses.
Yeah, that's it, Louis Theroux. Yeah. He's got a documentary when he goes.
And he's
America.
Kinda nerdy.
Yeah. There's an episode, yeah, when he goes and he goes to somebody. It's called The Paradise for Paedophiles, bruv. And it's literally just
the paradise
for paedophiles. Yeah, it's like literally a rehab center for pedos, bruv.
This is what I'm saying. They get a slap on the wrist.
Yeah, it's mad. Literally, man.
It's classed as mental health.
Yeah, and they assess their shit. So yeah.
They get a slap on the wrist. Rapists get a slap on the wrist. It's kind of mad. Like, it's just.
Bruv, that documentary is mad.
They should get steep sentences, like proper.
Facts. I agree with that.
Just go into the normal community in the jail. But they won't. They can't really do that because they'll get targeted, innit?
Bruv, when you watch the Louis Theroux one, yeah, they literally, this guy, he has like posters on his wall of like kid ballet dancers, innit? And they come and assess him and they're like, do you think this is appropriate? And they're like, oh, like what age range would you say the people in this picture are? And he's like, they're about 15, 16. And the guy's like, so do you feel that looks like an adult male? And he's like, I'm working on it. I was like, what the fuck, bruv?
Sounds like Michael Jackson, bruv.
They all sound like that up in there, bruv.
I said, I'm working on it.
That's what they sound like. They're trying to, bruv, it's a mad thing. It's like some kid ballet dancers, bruv. It's mad disturbing. Mad shit. You should watch Software Underbelly, bruv. They got mad interviews like that, bruv.
Yeah, I've seen some of them.
Man. Software Underbelly, bruv.
I've seen some of them.
A heroin addict guy, bruv. His arm was all nyam out, bruv. It was mad.
I've seen some of them still.
And here's the, look at this, another topic, bruv. OnlyFans, yeah? They're looking to move away from porn, yeah, as it's now worth $1 billion. So they're looking to be more business friendly. I knew that would happen, bruv.
Yeah.
Knew that would happen.
Yeah.
Whenever, you know what, whenever something is like, whenever something's a bit too X-rated and they start getting bare fucking people on it, they start changing up the thing, bruv. Everything starts going commercial. I don't think that's good, though. I think the porno things and like the some of the Instagram girls, bruv, like, that's their money, innit? Do you know what I mean? Yeah, that's their peas, bruv.
They can still get the peas, though.
How?
What are they stopping the porn thing?
Completely? Well, basically, like,
or like selling sex and all of that.
I guess it's one of them things where, like, if you got naked photos or like you're sending people like pussy pictures and shit, maybe they're putting a stop to that.
Good.
No, why, bruv? The girls need to eat, bruv.
Fuck them, man.
What do you mean?
Fuck that, man.
So what are they supposed to do, bruv? Sell their body, bruv.
Yeah.
Nah, bro. Come on, that's a safe way to do it, bro. They just, you know, some girl are making like 500 sending pussy pictures, bro.
Bro, listen, some of them girls are scamming, man, bro.
What do you mean? I feel like you. I feel like a girl scammed your OnlyFans, bro. You got Vim,
never,
bro.
Never.
You got Vim. You.
They can't scam me. A girl's actually tried to tell me to suck my nan, and she's got OnlyFans.
She told you to suck your nan.
Yeah.
Why did that bother you, bro? Like, because she's got OnlyFans.
No. Listen, she told me to suck my nan, and I said, "All right, cool." I clicked on her profile. She's got OnlyFans. I said to my mate, pay the little subscription and go into all the videos. And I said to her, listen, when you're promoting your stuff, I'm going to be there making the people watch it for free.
What? Yeah? So you're pirating somebody's OnlyFans?
Yeah, bruv. And then she got nervous.
Bruv, of course she thinks you're a fucking psycho, bruv.
Yeah, of course I am.
You're just there for your shades. It's like,
yeah, you fucking bitch.
You're like,
You know what I'm trying to say? And she backed off.
Bruv, Jason,
You know what I'm trying to say?
Fucking bitch. Fucking slags.
That's don't have OnlyFans and try to cuss anyone. We'll get your whole fucking footage.
The only thing I think that's bizarre though, like literally, it's like, imagine if you're OnlyFans girl and you're making big peas off that, that's hard. But imagine this being like a regular thing.
Yeah, bury them don't make even dough like that.
That's the thing. I feel like you gotta be like a proper thing to be on there. I feel like regular things that ain't that nice, they shouldn't really be on OnlyFans, bruv. Nobody like imagine like you're not a super bad bitch, like nobody wants to pay to see your soggy titties, bruv.
But some people go on there and foot pictures and that, innit?
That's why is it? I don't understand, man, with the foot fetish. A foot is a foot to me, bruv.
Yeah, but you put the foot in your mouth.
Yeah, if it's with a thing that I like and it's the wife or something, yeah, I'll suck her toes, bruv.
Yeah, but have you got a sly foot fetish?
Nah, just fucking and we're super in the moment, and I'm super in the moment, bruv, so I'm sucking her toes. But it's but not like one of, I wouldn't care to see somebody's feet, bruv. Yeah, like, but, feet is dead. Like.
But watch this now. Remember, there's some people that friggin'. Remember, Pornhub is free, yeah? You can see all different categories on Pornhub. Anything you really want. And there's people that will still pay to get some gold deluxe fucking membership.
Do you know what it is though? Because there's some things though on Pornhub that's super crisp and you're just like, yo, I need to personally watch these things, bruv. Like, I need to see more of their content, bruv. Because I was on there the other day, yeah, and I was literally watching something. And it's like some dark skin things, just super thick. A weave was beautiful. Everything was beautiful. And I was
and
like,
I said the weave was beautiful.
The weave was beautiful.
Come
bruv.
On, bro.
She had she had a beautiful baby. Yeah, bruv. She had a beautiful baby hair. She had her head tied up.
Okay, okay.
With the, like the Chinese ponytail thing like that. And I was like, yo, this thing is cold, bruv. And then I went on her page and everything was like 1 minute. I was like, yo, bruv. Oh,
you
want to
see like a 30 minute?
You want to see all, bruv. I want to see everything. And it's like, she had the thing where she was like doing the thing where she's just chatting. And then just before she's like about to play for herself, she's like, hey guys, welcome to my, and she's like, you can get this on my OnlyFans. I was like, ah, oh, fuck's sake, bro, I ain't paying for that shit.
Have you subscribed to OnlyFans?
Never. I would never pay to see gal naked. I just think that's bizarre, bruv. I never pay for sex. I'll never pay to see gal naked, bruv. That's mad. I've seen so many naked things in my life. Imagine paying for that, bruv. That's
but
mad.
This is what I'm saying. A lot of things are free and people still, did you get me? Like, still pay to watch certain things.
But yo, bruv, do you know the maddest thing though? How would you feel if you was dating a girl, yeah, and then literally somebody can pay £10 to see her pussy, bruv? That's a bit disturbing,
never,
bruv.
Never.
Imagine that, like, that's actually mad. Imagine somebody subscribing, it's like, yo, bruv, like, you're with your wifey at the Shard, bruv. You're like, yo, this is my queen, bruv. And they're like, yo, fam, like, I just paid £10 to see your girl's crutches,
bruv. Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. Are you gonna, could you wife a girl like that though?
No, not wife.
Yeah, so, but you could fuck a girl like that.
Yeah, of course.
But that's what I'm saying. You can't really, I don't know how people do that. Like, if anyone could see, like, that anyone could see your wife's body. It don't mean, like, it's weird.
So what if
like,
times got super hard, bruv?
For who?
Like, say if it was wife and times got super hard, bruv. She got to show some barty, bruv. On
super
the
hard for who? Me or
for her?
No, you're not ever going down that road. We're going to do something that's patterning you up.
Well, she's like, I don't want to pattern up. I want to show my pussy to people on OnlyFans.
No, you show your pussy there, and that's your life.
Well, she says it's my right, J-Gang, and you shouldn't be able to tell me nothing.
Do your fucking rights over there, then.
Where's it over there? Where she's like, this is me and you both live in this house.
Me and you's not living in that.
So what are you going to do? You're going to drag her
out? I'm going to go to my house.
No, but what if you two live together?
No, it's never like that. You always have to have your house, brother.
I like that. Good,
you can't.
Good.
You get me? You can't be under the roof, and then she goes, come out my house! Yeah, and you're like looking left and right.
Yeah,
sorry, babe.
You gotta get your Tom and Jerry bag, bruv. You gotta get your Tesco bag tied to stick, bruv. And just
you gotta be
go
able
home,
to
bruv.
Say,
it's mad.
All right, I'm going to my house then. Do you get what I'm trying to say?
Big man, it's a
if
mad
that's
thing,
the
you
case,
know.
Bro.
Do you know what? Yeah, like literally, would you make an OnlyFans?
For what?
For like your sex, content. Like yeah, like not for what you do, like your content. YouTube keeps on shadow banning you. What would you do?
Yeah, I'll definitely do an OnlyFans for that.
Manting.
Yeah. What? Okay, I'll do OnlyFans for my drink, bruv.
Let me ask you. So are you indirectly telling us you got OnlyFans, bruv?
No,
you got a Patreon, innit, bruv?
I'm gonna probably do when it turns to business, I'm gonna do one.
Do you know what the maddest thing is? Yeah, like what if somebody said, like, you know,
how imagine people, I watch this. Imagine I got OnlyFans gal drinking Zaza when they're doing their thing. That's mad. That's a good idea. You know what I'm trying to say?
Would you join in though?
Nah. What do you mean join in and doing what?
Like they're just pouring
the drink in their mouth.
No. Like literally, so some guys. So basically, the girl's on her knees. Yeah, some guy's got his dick in her mouth. Yeah, and you just got a Zaza potion. You're like Zaza potion, and then like you lot are doing the Meg Thee Stallion thing with his dick.
Nah,
his dick
in the mouth. That's when I hire you because you're the guy for them. You actually pull it off sick.
I was trying to set you up.
I'll hire you.
Like literally, dead. You're like, yeah, you do the Meg Thee Stallion rotorboat thing, Rev.
Yes.
Yeah, guys got sticking around you like Zaza.
Yeah, look, man. See, you're doing
it right now.
Don't worry, people.
You did a pop smoke.
Look at Costello. Look, see, this is what I'm saying. We got Costello on deck. Costello's got the blueprint. It's all right.
So I'm giving you marketing ideas,
that's what
bruv.
I'm saying.
Do you know what? I want to OnlyFans though, bruv. I want to be fucking on there in 32K, bruv. Fucking, bruv.
Are you serious about it?
Very serious, bruv.
All right, when you
like
when
real
you,
fucking, so, like for real.
When you want to start fucking on there.
Yeah.
Just let man sponsor it by Zaza Potion, so there's always Zaza in the place.
You get what but I'm I have to say? Charge you then, bruv.
You have to charge me.
I'm charging you, bruv.
Why?
Why the fuck am I letting you do that for free, bruv? You're making bare peas off my.
I'm sponsoring you.
Sponsor, but you ain't giving me no peas, bruv. So what are you sponsoring?
What do you mean?
Bruv? Your drink's just there. What am I getting from it, bruv?
Yeah, you're getting lifetime supply of
so
Zaza.
So 3 billion people watching me fucking, and they buying your thing, bruv. That's a bit mad.
That's what I'm saying.
So you're not going to break me. I have no money,
I'm going to break you, bro.
What country are you from, bruv?
Jamaica.
That's why, bruv. That's why. It's that Jamaican in you, bruv. You're trying to rob and con me.
I'm not trying to rob you, bro.
You're sleazeball, bruv. You're trying to not give me my peas, bruv.
We're helping each other out.
Nah, bruv. You're one of them guys, bruv. Big man ting, yeah. Look, there's another ting, yeah. Like, they're going to put this on screen, yeah. It's called the Molder Willy, bruv.
What?
I don't know what this is. I'm seeing it on the screen, bruv.
What? The Molder what?
It's called the Molder Willy, bruv. I see it on the screen here, bruv. If you look, can't see it, bruv. This is what they put a link up to. It's called, they're saying just read it, bruv. It's called a Molder Willy, yeah? Recreate his bit with a great new kit. So I guess then a gal can mold a man's willy, bruv.
Seeing as I and M come in here, this is what's happening.
That's mad, bruv. What is a...
Don't look around, bruv. I didn't want to say your full name. Yeah, but as soon as you come in, we see Molder Willy. I don't know what you're on, bro.
Yo, Mike came in with a towel. Oh, I thought you were in a turtleneck today, bruv. You coming in suave, cuz.
That's what I'm saying.
Mike came in from a date, bruv. Man took her to the fine Nando's, bruv, in Greenwich, bruv, with a rooftop view, bruv. Mad ting. Big man ting. Real talk, yeah. We're not going to talk about that Molder Willy thing. That's a bit mad, bruv. Yeah? So big man ting. Oh, so let me ask you this, yeah. With the OnlyFans thing, would you do sex toys, bruv?
Yeah.
Would you?
Yes.
So you would mold your willy on the sex toy?
No. Do you know the sex toy?
Do you know the maddest thing though? What if somebody say to you, like, J Gang, like, literally, wanna invest in you, like, we want a porno with you and a gal in it, yeah, and it will pay you a million. Would you do that for OnlyFans?
With what girl?
A girl that you're seeing or a girl that you're dating or whatever?
No.
You wouldn't? £1 million, change your life?
Nah, man.
2 million.
I said 2 million. I have to go to speak to my team.
Your team. Let's go to the crackheads in Brixton, like, yo, cuz, what you lot think about
it? Nah, this, man, like, no money could, what's it? Nah, bro, that's...
For 2 million?
To do what? Fuck who? It's like they're trying to set you up. Why are you going to give me 2 million to sex?
Because they like you, they like J-Gang, they like the brand, they like the shades, they like the image.
I don't believe it.
Do you know what I mean? But if the money's real, that's what I'm saying, it's legit.
Nah, I'm good, man.
5 million, man.
That means, man said 5 million.
5 million, bro.
But they're not going to, that's a... Big hypothetical blood clot situation, bro.
But what if it happened, though?
It wouldn't happen.
They want to brand you, bruv.
Nah, man, it wouldn't.
You get me, bruv? You feel you?
5 million, that's big dough, you know?
That's what I'm saying. That's why you're on it.
No, but they wouldn't do that. It don't make sense.
Bruv, you'd be surprised, bruv. There's mad sponsors out there, bruv.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? But like I said, bruv, the OnlyFans thing, it's something I want to do, bruv. Like, literally, like, I'm going to channel the spirit of Wesley Pipes, bruv.
I don't believe that you're on it.
I'm fully on it, bruv.
I don't believe you are.
Like 100%.
Seeing is believing, bro.
Bruv, you what? Seeing is believing. Yeah. Yo, you're a disturbing guy.
Man's saying, whoa.
Seeing is believing, bruv.
That he'll be fucking a girl on OnlyFans.
Would you subscribe to my OnlyFans, bruv?
Huh?
Would you subscribe
I won't subscribe. But I'll look at the fat thing that you're beating on there.
Yeah, bruv. Should be cold though, bruv. Sexy fat thing.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Do you like fat things?
I'll support.
Do you like fat things? Or you like more
I don't
of a skinny?
Discriminate.
Or do you like a slender petite thing?
Depends.
You like petite things?
Depends.
I can't imagine if a petite thing, you know.
What, small petite?
Like, let's say like 5 foot four, slim, like 10 stone, 11 stone, like fitness model.
Don't discriminate.
I don't know.
I know you're trying to.
Nah, I'm trying to figure out.
Yeah, I know you are.
Because you look like you'd like to fit things.
Don't discriminate.
I like that, bro. This guy's sick. This guy's sick, bro. You're good, bro. You're good. My interrogation skills didn't work, bro. Big man team, we got a caller. You're now locked into the Friday night round. What are you saying, G?
What is that, Casillo? Yeah.
Yeah, well gone, brother.
Yeah, Casillo, well gone, my G. What are you saying, bruv?
Yeah, not blessed, too bad, bruv. Yeah, man. Living life in that, man. How are you?
Yeah, bro. I'm blessed. I'm in Asia still. I'm in Asia right now still.
Are you in Asia? Which country?
Hey, you know Singapore.
Singapore, it's nice. What are you doing over there?
You're not in Asia, bro. You're not
big
in
man,
Asia.
I've been out here for a while.
You're not in Asia.
No, we're lying. I'm in Asia. We're lying. Look at big man. Look, Jay Gang, stop saying shit.
Listen,
bro.
You
look
stop chatting shit. Shut the fuck up, bro.
Look at my dial code.
You're not going to come in here and chat shit.
Look at my dial code.
Is he in Asia for real?
Is he in Asia? I can't see the dial code.
Talk to Casillo.
What's your dilemma?
Big man thing.
What
do
you do? Did you get stuck out there? Talk up. What's your dilemma?
No, big man. I've been there for a while still. But
What's your dilemma? I've been there for a while. What's happening?
Basically, long story short, I was here from early. Yeah. I've been here for fucking three, four years now. And
yeah, yeah.
But one of my first brethren I met here and it was from fucking ENDS as well. But he moved to Bangkok recently, innit?
Yeah.
So I was like, calm. That's blessed. Have a good time, right there. But basically, he keeps sending me pictures of yachts, isn't it? He keeps sending me pictures of yachts, like, yo, I'm trying to cut this thing, I'm trying to beat that thing.
Are they transgenders? Innit?
What?
Are they transgenders?
Maybe. Yeah, that's the problem.
Bangkok's got the...
No, that's what I'm saying to you, man, innit? That's what I'm saying to you, man, innit? Maybe, innit? Maybe. Yeah. Car, my problem... No, this is my dilemma to you, man, innit? Car, basically, we've been in Singapore early from, like, doing things, being yachts, whatever... Living life, we've been having a fun time here for fucking 2-3 years now, innit?
Yeah,
obviously, my dog moved to fucking Thailand, innit? So, what I'm saying is, like, he's like, yo, Thailand. I'm in Thailand now.
Thailand's because the place for that, you know?
Yeah,
no, but what I'm saying to you, man, is it's different because obviously, me and my brethren, we've got a little click in that in Singapore, but obviously, lockdown for fucking COVID is peak. Me and my brethren, myself included, we can't do nothing. We can't do nothing in Singapore. Car is lockdown, isn't it? It's lockdown. We can't go to raves. We can't do nothing.
Shit, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. So basically, my brethren about 6 months ago, thereabouts, moved to Bangkok. He's like, yo, I'm doing my thing, right? Because it's true say in Thailand, not Singapore, in Thailand, you can do your thing. You can go raving, you can
everything,
do your thing.
Yeah, more freedom.
So basically, man's sending me pictures of yachts, and my brethren's like, These things, what I want advice for you, man, is like your brethren send you pictures of things that look like man.
Yeah, bruv, maybe your brethren likes that man pussy, bruv. Maybe he likes that bussy, bruv.
No. Allow me, Casillo.
It could be, bruv. Maybe he likes that. Maybe he's in, like maybe he's entering some transgender parties, bruv.
Listen, finish off what you're saying, big man, and let us.
No. What I'm saying, simple as that. Yeah, basically, yeah. Man's been to Bangkok like fucking. A year ago, 6 months ago, we have WhatsApp group, all the men have WhatsApp group, yeah. The man's like, yo, look at this thing, look at that thing. I'm not gonna lie to you, man, yeah. Like, fucking 50% on my life, wallahi, on my life, wallahi, 50% of the things are looking like man, damn it. But he's gassed,
Do you know what? Maybe, what do I do?
I don't want to hurt man's feelings, innit? Car, that's my guy, innit?
Do you know what you should do? You should make him watch Hangover. Have you watched Hangover?
Hey, but I know there's things.
Have you watched Hangover?
I've been dropping bars. I've been dropping them bars there because I've been.
But it's not about not hurting his feelings, bro. Like,
he's not silly, Jay Gang. He's not silly though. He knows about them things there.
All right, but I'm telling
him.
So just like what Costello said, he might like that.
That's
type
what I'm
of
trying
stuff.
To say. Maybe do you know what it is? Yeah, maybe because he's so used to it. Maybe like he's so used to fucking gal. Yeah, now he's just on this thing, innit? Like maybe he likes getting sucked off by some. Dude, like that, bruv, called Roberto de Santos, bruv. Maybe that's his name. No,
man can't come back. Man can't come back to fucking ends. And even though you live in Singapore, man can't come back like talking that talk there. So obviously, man's not going to say what he feels.
Nah, but
every time I see these women on WhatsApp, I'm like, rah. Like, what are we doing? What is happening, bruv? What is happening here?
I think maybe your brother's just on that alternative lifestyle, bruv. Maybe that's what it is, bruv.
What, Creed on there?
Bruv, maybe he's just on getting that pussy, bruv. That man pussy, bruv. You get what I'm just saying? Maybe that's what he's on now, bruv. Maybe that's his new path in life.
On my life. Aye, Castillo, on my life, though. He's not like that, bruv. He's not a fruity don, bruv. He likes pussy, fam. Trust me. He likes
maybe,
pussy.
Maybe them things, I know from maybe he, in his mind, he can convince himself that those things are gal, innit? Do you know what I mean? Maybe in his mind, he's feeling that, bruv. Because literally,
if I had your fucking Instagram, what it says, I'll put a picture to you of some yachts here. You'll be like, can you send me a picture?
Look, I'm on my Instagram now.
No, I can't. On my life, I'm not even chatting shit to you. I can't right now because it's too quick. I need to go on fucking do missions for that. But what you understand is, man sending me pictures right there all the time, like, yo, this thing's fire. That thing's there.
So let me ask you this. Yeah, are you like 99.9% sure the things, some of the things that you slay there, 100% gal?
Oh my!
No, not on the road.
Not at all.
You're not 100% sure.
That's the problem. Huh? That's the problem. No, not at all. Not at all, fam. Them things look like they got willies, fam. I'm saying
well, you've been there for a while. Some of the things that you smashed.
How do you know 100%
that some of them things?
Not even, bruv. I know what I like. I know what I like, fam. Yeah, trust me, I know what I like.
But then today, some of them look better than gal, bruv. Some of them convincing ones, bruv.
I don't know about
that. Have you seen some of the Brazilian things, bruv? The Brazilian things, bruv. Some of them things look better than gal, bruv. Them things look like Marvel superheroes, bruv. Them things look amazing.
Big man. Come on, I'm a big man myself, bruv. I don't do them things there. But look, my brethren, basically, long story short, my brethren's telling me, like, look, I've moved to Bangkok. I'm trying to live my best life. Right? I tell him, like, good for you. Live your best life. Sure, let me. All right, what are you doing? Oh, here's a picture. I'm like, big man, I'm not sure about that. But I have to respect him because if he's happy, if he's trying to get willy, he's trying to get pussy, whatever he wants to do, because I'm like, cool.
Bruv,
I don't discriminate.
The fact that he's sending you some pictures of some of these things, bruv, yeah, I think low-key he's trying to like let you know, like, yeah, bruv, I know, man. I'm just showing you, man's dealing with some of these Robitos, bruv. They're looking kind of sweet. Mm. Yeah, but he's just trying to show you that's his thing now. Do you know what I mean?
Nah, I thought, bro, you said
you don't discriminate, yeah? So, yeah. How, you're not hurting his feelings by asking him, like, bro, like, you should just be real with him and say, brother, some of these things look like they're, do you get what I'm trying to say? And then see what he says. That's what you should do.
To be fair, Jay Gang, there's been occasions. Even when he was in Singapore with me before he moved, I said to him, I goes, brother, this looks a bit shifty, fam. And he was like, yo, no, it's not even. Bruv, obviously, I think man's in denial or whatever.
Bruv, we've got to wrap up the call, yeah, but all I'm saying is this, yeah, this is just one of them ones where you're just going to have to accept man for what he's doing, yeah? I'm just saying, all you can do is be a friend, bruv, and try and guide him in the right way, bruv, because literally, bruv, you just got to make sure that he's on the right path, bruv, because literally, 8th Street is real close, bruv. That's L5, bruv. You get what I'm trying to say? One wrong turn, bruv, and you'll be taking them medications for the rest of your life, bruv. Losing your T-cells, bruv. Big man T.
Listen, Castillo, yeah? All I got to say before I go, yeah?
Go on, bruv.
Fucking Sniper, wavy tune, bruv. I've
big
been
man
T.
Love for that,
so.
My brother. Love for that, G.
Safe, thanks my guy. And Jay Gang,
See, he's going to chat shit. Rashid had my back, you see?
Manting.
See what happened to you? Yeah? You're in fucking Singapore beating the Sheehys. You're fucking air talking. You was about to chat shit. You tried.
Big man ting. Huh? So I'm reading some of the comments.
Fucking
it says,
failed.
Somebody asked, how does J-Gang know about the I-Boys, the L-Boys?
What's the L-Boys?
The L-Boys.
What's that?
The L-Boys in Bangkok.
Because I watched, Ladyboys, because I watched Hangover.
Ah, got you.
That's why, if that person was fucking listening, I said, tell your boy to watch Hangover.
Mad thing.
You fucking twit.
Somebody said here, somebody said they're moving to Bangkok.
What?
Somebody in the comments says they're moving to Bangkok, bruv. Yeah, I'm trying to say, big man thing. Somebody said here, somebody said that guy's calling for himself, bruv. That's true. Big man thing, yeah, he now logged into the Friday Night Run. What are you saying?
Hi, you okay?
Hey, what's good? We got a lady on the line. How you doing, babes? How's your evening going?
Yes, better now speaking to you guys.
Hey, that's what we like to hear. That's what we like to hear.
Why is he not saying hi?
Oh, hello. Sorry. I was in my own way. Hello. What's your name, darling?
Candice.
Don't know. Sweet one. What's your dilemma for tonight?
So it's a bit tricky. So basically, I have a boyfriend. First of all, I just wanted to ask, where are you guys both from, like, nationality-wise?
Nationality-wise? I'm Dominican and Grenadian. My dad's Indian from Grenada. My mum's black from Dominica.
My parents are from Jamaica.
Okay, fine.
Where are you from?
I'm Greek.
You're Greek. Ooh, okay.
Greek things, exotic things there.
She's got a boyfriend, big man. Are you on?
Thank you. No, it's fine.
Yeah, go on. What's your dilemma?
Basically, he's so I've got this boyfriend, and he's from Nigeria. Basically, like, obviously, before I was always with like English guys, and it's kind of weird because the kind of things that he's like doing, I'm just finding really strange.
Like what?
Hey, I saw you're Nigerian, like, big man. Go on. Listen.
Basically, I brought him to my parents' house. Yeah. It was just like, it was all fine. And then he was just asking like a lot of questions like about their finances and stuff.
What? Yeah. What? You gotta tell your parents that had their bank cards, bruv. That's a bit mad.
Well, basically, I spoke to some of my friends and, you know, they said that was quite strange.
So what?
And then like...
Go on.
And then basically like other things like the food that he like wants me to try and cook and the food that he's like eating is like, you know,
what kind of you don't really like, you don't like the food that he's cooking?
Jollof.
Well, it's like some soup things and like animal heads and stuff.
Oh, the goat heads.
You don't want to, did you give it a try?
I think it is. I don't want to try it, like goat feet or something like that. I don't even know what it is, and it's just, I feel like laughing.
It'll make you strong, you know. You see, you eat them food there, you'll be able to run into a wall and break it. Yeah.
So you like that? So you don't like the hard food in that?
No, and then he doesn't like my Greek food.
So what's your kind of like dishes? Like,
what's your traditional Greek dish?
Like. We eat like a little kebab kind of thing.
See, kebabs, that's too soft for them. And they listen.
Kebab,
listen,
no. But what else? Though? I feel like there's more to it than just kebabs. Do you know what I mean?
That's what they're on. That kebab and beef and like.
So he doesn't like that type of stuff.
Yeah, but them and they want strong back food, brother. You get me? He can lift you up, innit? He can lift you up.
So is he giving you that? So he's trying to give you that agusi soup.
Can he lift you up?
Yes, that's it. That's the one.
Agusi soup.
Can he lift you up?
Can he lift me up?
Yeah.
Well, he has once when we were first together. Yeah, just once. And like, also, he takes my bank card sometimes now. And
What's he buying of that?
Well, the thing is, he withdraws money and stuff, so I can't really see what he's buying.
So, how much money is he withdrawing every time?
Sorry, how much is he withdrawing? God, the most was like £300.
Oh, I see.
So when you asked him, like, what are you buying?
Who is this on the phone? It's my friend. Get off. It's my friend. Get off.
What? Mr. J-Gang, is this your friend? J-Gang, is this your people?
I'm leaving. I've had enough. I'm going to go back. Caribbean boys,
I had enough of
you. You stink. Your food and your family, everything. I'm leaving.
How did he box on her face?
I'm so sorry. He tried to come in and like.
Is everything all right, Elijah? I mean, tap once on the phone if everything's okay. Tap once.
Yes, everything's fine. He's not going to come back in the room. I don't think.
So wait,
is this your yard?
What did you say? Sorry?
Is this your house or his house?
Yeah, it's my house. I'm going to attempt to get out.
So, wait, I'm confused.
I'm mad confused.
Wait a minute.
He stinks. He doesn't even wash his armpits. It's disgusting.
So then why are you with him? Are you dating like some uncle, bruv?
His armpit. I can see you. Get out of my house.
What?
Even when he comes out the shower,
yeah,
they stink straight.
Nah, man, you're moving, man. At first, I was convinced. You nearly had me. There's no African man in your house. I think there's a bit of racism going on there.
There's no Africa.
Why do you get offended?
Why are you getting offended, man?
You're not even Jamaican anyway. You're from Congo. So
you're from
Congo. So you shut up anyway.
All right.
Is your name Yoda?
All right, Kaffi.
Is your name Yoda?
All right, Kaffi.
Hello.
Who's this? Hello, real Wagwan, brother.
You was doing an act.
Are you giving your girl a panda eyes, brother? It sounds like you did some matting.
Shut your mouth. Who the fuck is this?
Bro.
Big menting. Link Up TV does not condone wife beating, bruv.
Bro.
What's going on, bruv?
Whose friend is that?
What's going on? What's going on,
my brother? She said that your armpits and your food stinks, brother.
What, is this the same people on the phone?
Yeah.
Oh. What are you talking about?
Hello, big man. What do you want? What do you want me and Costello's
What do you mean, what do you want?
Wait, one second. Sir, what is the problem here? Talk to us. What's going on?
Welcome on, brother.
Like, what's happening? What?
Listen.
Is she on her period tonight?
Are you
what's going on?
Are you boxing your girl, bruv? Are you trying to give your girl the panda eyes, bruv? What are you doing?
Who the fuck is this on the phone?
Big man.
Us, bro.
You know what?
Listen.
Aye, cut this book, man. This guy's just trying to be a shit. All right, sir. Thank you, sir. England's playing.
This guy, who the fuck is this guy? That was the weirdest shit ever, bruv.
That was weird. They done they
that's
was,
some weird role
they
play.
Was making this role play from last week,
bruv. Yeah. I feel like that girl calls that man nigger in bed, bruv. Because why would he go along with this?
That's what I'm saying.
They're doing some slave play, bruv.
That's what I'm saying. She's a white woman.
Yeah, they're doing
she's
some.
She's a black man.
Yeah, they're doing some.
And she's talking about the man tried to give her all goosey soup.
Bruv, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
bruv.
And then she's doing all this bruv, stuff on
doing
the phone.
Some, they're doing some slave play things. She's going, yeah. Fuck me with that black cock, you black bastard. That's what she's doing, yeah, bruv. Yeah. This is mad disturbing, bruv. Who is that, bruv?
Hey, listen. Wait. You see that number? We're going to plaster it for you. Don't worry.
We're going to promote
that,
bruv.
Yeah, we got you.
J-Gang's going to write down some cubicles, bruv.
Yeah, we got you.
This is why you're going to write a name on the thing. Yeah.
You're going to have to change that number. Yeah? You better hold that in your contract number now.
Get me. Big menting. That is a menting. What the fuck? We got any more calls on the line?
Hello.
Yo, Wagwan, my brother. You're now locked into the Friday Night Run. What are you saying, G?
Yo, what are you saying? You remember me, yeah?
Huh? Nah.
So, I had a question for you, though. I don't know if you can help me, but basically...
Wait, they remember you
from
where?
You said, where would we remember you from?
Where would we remember you from? And someone's laughing.
You don't remember me.
No.
Someone's laughing.
You don't remember me.
No. How would we remember
you? Who's laughing in the back? Who's laughing in the back?
Where do we remember you from?
You might remember... Can I speak?
Big man, you're stuttering. Where do we remember you from? Hurry up,
let me tell you my issue. And you remember me.
No, all right, go on then.
Go on.
So, listen. So, last week, I went to this shop, right? And I went to buy some clothes, and I got to the till, and it was J-Gang.
Yeah.
And guess what shop it was?
Matalan.
This guy, bro.
No, but Costello, I can't let you off.
You can't let him off.
Go on.
Matalan. Yeah.
This guy, bro. This guy's an idiot, bro. He's still going with a Matalan thing.
Waited 2 months to do
two
that.
2 months, I know, bruv. The only call, bruv, he waited, bruv.
Yeah? You waited 2 months.
That is a man thing.
Man's with his brethren laughing in the back. Like, cuz, quickly do the Matalan joke, quickly. That is...
He's like, yeah, bruv, do the Matalan thing. Yeah. Bruv, do the Matalan. Then they go...
You know, are hidden in the yard talking about Matalan.
Then they go and suck each other's dicks, bruv. This is a mad life they're living. Can't understand it.
Full serve for you lot, man.
Big man, that's what the man them are doing on a Friday night, aren't you, though, bruv? That's
I'm
mad.
Saying England's playing, bruv.
Yeah, no, England's playing, bruv. Like,
your mum and dad's from England, bruv. Yeah, watch the match. The thing, bruv. Watch the fucking match. You're here worried about us. Actually, you're worried about me.
Big man, team.
Talk about Costello. I can't let you off. Hello.
You're now
sir.
Locked into the Friday night run. What are you saying, G?
Hello, it's the girl.
Hey, what's good? You're now locked into Friday night run. How are you?
Hi, I'm calling basically. My picture's actually real. But basically what's going on is I had a child and basically we've now part ways where we cannot be together anymore and we have respect for each other. Everything's going on.
Mm-hmm.
And he helped me with my career and everything because I'm a nurse now. I'm only 23 as well.
Oh, well done. That's
and
good.
Basically I have a child now and now I'm trying to move on and basically get to know like new people. It's kind of like hard for me and I met a guy and it was really good. We went on a date and everything and basically what happened was he was basically saying his family wouldn't accept my child if he was to like get far with me and I kind of felt a certain way.
Yeah.
And I felt like I did everything. Like, I felt like I did everything right. And I kind of was kind of stuck in a situation where I was just thinking, like, I have everything that you say you want in a girl, but then you don't want to, like, date someone with a child because I have a kid. Mm-hmm. And then, like, yeah, so basically, that's my dilemma, basically.
Do you know what the thing about that is? Yeah, it's a mad one because the craziest thing, you could have a lot going for you. I think because you're still young. How old was the guy?
He was 25.
That's the thing, you see.
The thing is,
I feel like until you get older and you start meeting more mature men where that's not going to be a thing, a lot of young guys are going to have that mentality where they're like, I can't date a girl, I can't wife a girl with a child or whatever.
But I think it's when you get the parents that was saying.
The parents, that's what I'm trying to say, because it's like, that's what I mean about the maturity thing. Because he's still a young guy, his parents still have a lot of like a lot of influence over his decision making, innit? Okay, if he was dating a big man wouldn't really be thinking about them things there, because a big man's operating on his own thing. So like, I know it's a bit mad to say like, oh, just wait for the right guy. Like, literally, you might have to wait for the right guy, or it's just a thing where time will have to happen. Because like I said, I'm not gonna lie, when I was like 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, I had that same mentality. Like,
a lot of years.
Yeah. Do you know what I mean? Like, but I just had that thing where I was like, I can't. Take a girl with a child seriously. I can't do that. Like, I want to start my own family. But then as you get older, you look at it a bit differently, because now you're looking at the woman as an individual. And then another thing as well is you might have children yourself on the man's side. Yeah. You know what I'm trying to say? So it's a thing where it might just keep on happening as you're still young. But as you get older, you're not going to have that problem.
So wait there. So what is he saying? Obviously, the parents are saying that. What is he saying?
He's saying that basically he doesn't have a problem with it, like he doesn't mind children or anything.
Yeah.
But he knows if he was a thing where we got serious and we're gonna settle down, it's basically a thing he would be like worried to tell his dad.
Oh, so his dad basically disown him.
There you go.
It's a thing like he can't be open about such thing, because his child will be like, oh, basically, you know, you don't even have your own seed, but you want to take care of someone else's seed. That's basically what he was trying to explain.
That's the thing. And you see, the thing is, because he's 20, like I said, he's 23. I mean, he said he's 25. His parents got his parents got influence over him. Do you know what I'm trying to say? But if he was a big man, he'd be moving his own direction and how he wants to move. So it's not a thing where, although he wants to do that, the fact that his parents got all that influence on him, it's going to be tricky for you. Do you know what I'm trying to say? You might as well just cut your losses and get with someone where you're not having to worry about their parents. Do you know what I'm trying to say? Because that's just a long thing. You can't be in a relationship with someone and be worrying about their parents' input on your shit. That's a mad thing.
Yeah.
How do you feel about that? Because do you really like this person?
I feel like I don't have like any problems. I just feel like it's a thing. Like, I didn't see why, and I was trying to understand that situation, because we didn't really go in depth in it, because I didn't want to speak about. I kind of like left the situation and like really disrespected me, and I basically just came back home and just said, you know, let me call it a time. But I didn't actually hear his point. But I was like, okay, let me come and watch, because I always watch this. Let me just ask someone on like an actual platform that will actually hear what other people, or been around with other people and the stuff like that.
Yeah.
Do you know what it is? Yeah. Do you know what it is? I'll tell you the reason why a lot of guys have that mentality and a lot of people's parents have that mentality is because, like, as a parent and all that stuff, obviously you want the best for your child. And it's like a lot of parents, when they hear their son or daughter's dating somebody for child, all these different stereotypes and different kind of assumptions come into their mind, innit? So they're like, she's 23 for child. Where's the father? What's the father doing with his life? What's she doing with her life? What age did she have this child? Are you sure that the baby father's not on drugs? What if you get with this girl and then the baby father wants to have more input in the child's life? Now there's all this stress. So parents always think about that for their own children. Do you know what I'm trying to say? So that's the thought process that goes into it. So it's not even a thing where it's like, I don't even feel like it's coming from a bad place. It's just sometimes comes from a place where parents just want the best for their kids. And like I said, it's just them assumptions that people come. So you might be the perfect person, but then they're not even thinking about you. They're thinking, okay, you're cool. You might have your life situation, but what about the guy in his life? What happens if their son gets with you, you are together for 10 years, and all of a sudden your baby father comes back and he wants to be in the child's life? All these different things go through their mind as to why they don't. Do you understand?
But that's like, the thing, yeah. You're saying that they don't want it like that, but a guy, my child's father's in the life, and guys, I see that guys basically would rather take a girl who ain't got the child in the dad's life, but it's like, I'm doing things the right way. My child's father's there. He does everything for the child. He's very supportive, like, and you would rather see me as a single mom struggling than
his parents.
Like, it's kind of confusing to me, but then there's some guys that will, like, accept it now, like will say, okay, yeah, I don't mind having talking to a girl with a child because it's not like a problem to me. It's more how the girl acts, how I would feel towards the child. And it's kind of like, huh? How does that make any sense either? How are you gonna? Go on. So if I act bad, you're gonna base that off how my child is. I'm confused. Like,
you just got to look at it like this. Either way you split it, you're damned if you do, damned if you don't. Only because some parents, for example, they might even be traditional. Some parents are like, no, I want my son to have his own wife and his own child. I don't want that woman that my child gets with, or my son to get with, to have other children. I don't want my son to be co-parenting somebody else's child. I don't want him to have that influence. I don't want him to have this weird sort of baby mum, baby father kind of issues. That's how some people just look at it. Some people just like, no, just find a girl that doesn't have kids and then you start your own family. And some people, like, as bad as it sounds and as perfect as the girl is, some people just not budge from that mind state. Do you want to say, even you yourself, for example, because you're experiencing it, have you got a daughter or a son?
A son.
So, for example, when you maybe like reach a certain age, like let's say like you're in your 40s or something, and your son's maybe, let's say, he's like 18, 19, like, or whatever, and then he says like, or let's say he's like 20 something, yeah, and he gets off a girl and then he's like, yeah, I'm dating this girl and she's got two kids. You might then feel about it a bit differently, even though you've been in that position. Even you might then have your own biases, like, why has this girl got two kids like at her age? You might come with your own things, you know what I mean? So you kind of got to cut the parents some slack because they just want the best for their son. But at the same time, for me, what I would do if I was you, I'd just focus on my child. I'd just focus on my youth and make sure that I give everything to my youth.
But how would you say someone who feels like they're in the right space in life and they want to date out again, how would you say to them to go about it?
I would say just date and do your thing, but until you know that guy is the right guy, don't bring him anywhere near your kids and just keep that separate until you know for sure, like, that's the guy and he's going to be cool with it. Because the worst thing you don't want is to be dating and doing your things, then it flops, and then you introduce some next man to your child, then it flops, then you introduce some next man to your child, then it flops, and then next thing you know, your son's met all these random men that you never really had anything with. Do you get what I mean?
Yeah, but remember, the boys are right with it, but it's just the parents.
His parents are the ones with the problem.
This is what I'm saying.
Because he's fine, like, he's been through, he's seen how I am and everything, but he's just like, look, I don't know if I want to bring you through that situation. Like, I know how my dad is, especially. And I was just like, whoa, like, is it that bad where you can't actually tell dad? Because I'm Caribbean, and I know if I took a guy with a child and I didn't have a child, my family would be, like, more accepting of it. They would be like, okay, as long as you know what you're doing. They would be careful.
Where's he? What's the African?
Yeah.
Okay.
But what's it? Listen, Nigerian. we gotta like wrap the call up. But all I'll say is this year, like I said, this date, and don't introduce no man to your kids until it's the right one. And what I'll say is this though, don't ever get with a guy or take a guy seriously where their parents has that much influence in their life, because you're always gonna be battling his parents forever. It's long.
Yeah, 100%.
So yeah, that's my advice to you.
And they might not even like your son just because of that.
So yeah, thanks for calling in, man. I hope that kind of helped a little bit.
Love.
Yeah, thank you.
Big man thing. We're going to read some comments, bruv. There are people saying that's some good advice. Some people saying she's trying to force the guy. Somebody said she's a female. She ain't listening to anything. Just saying, bro. It just goes in one ear and out the other. Somebody said I should be agony uncle. Bruv, I've dated bare women with children, bruv. It's not that bad. When you get older, you just need to expect that women have children, bruv. You can't. It just is what it is. Do you know what I'm trying to say? Depending, you just got to make sure that she's a decent woman. Do you know what I mean? That's it. Big man thing. Have we got any more callers? Oh, yeah. Oh, has the results for the England-Scotland match come through? Huh? It's a draw. Done. That was
finished.
Draw. Done, bruv.
Fucking it. I thought Big Scotland was going to take it.
So you see that, bruv? You see? There was no point in watching that shit, bruv. You should have looked into the Friday night rant, bruv. That's what you should have done, bruv. Get me?
No.
Mad thing. That was a waste of fucking time. Mad thing. Might as well have not did that shit. Right, let me see some comments, bruv.
They must be pissed out there.
Of course, right, bruv. One said, somebody said she's young and a child is young. Just focus on growing up with your child. Facts. She's got a deep. He don't want her to. If he did, he would sort it. Somebody said, most dead game. England drew match was disappointed. Mismanagement. She'll find someone when she focuses on her child. He'll come randomly. Yeah, that's a good advice, bruv. That's some good one, bruv.
Yeah, but she is focusing on her child.
Exactly, bruv. That's so, in the long run, that's all good, bruv. Imagine that, bruv. A fucking draw.
That is shit, bruv.
So basically, what happens after they have a draw? Like, what happens then?
I don't even know. I say it's early stages. It's just, I don't know. Yeah, it's just the groups. It's just points right now, isn't it?
So what's your prediction then for who's going to win? I don't even watch football, so I'm just...
What for the what is this? What's going on? Is it a tournament? Is it world? Is it the World Cup?
I thought it was the World Cup, bruv. I'm not gonna lie to you, bruv.
African Cup of Nations.
What's it called? The African Cup. So why is Scotland and England playing? So is that, are you taking a piss? The African Cup of Nations.
You're lying, man.
You're trying. This guy's a dickhead.
African Cup of Nations, though.
How about the African Cup of Nations? I was like, yo, why are England and Scotland playing for the cup, bruv? Oh, it's the Euros, bruv. That's how I don't know about football.
I don't. Yeah.
Somebody said you really don't watch football now, bruv. I don't watch boxing, bruv. I just watch. What sport do you watch?
That's what I'm talking about. What's it called? We forgot.
Fury Wilder.
Yeah.
I'm going with Wilder, bruv. You've got to root for the underdog.
Why, though?
Because I love Wilder, bruv. He's a G.
But why do you love him, though?
Because he's the underdog.
Wilder's not going to win.
He might.
No, because...
Let's make a bet, bruv.
What do you want to bet? A ton?
£1,000.
You don't want to bet £1,000.
I'm betting £1,000, bruv.
Do you want to bet £1,000
for real? £1,000 for real.
Who's
going to knock him out?
What?
I mean, sorry. Wilder's going to knock Fury out.
So you want to bet £1,000?
Yeah.
That Wilder knocks out
Fury. Yeah.
If he don't knock out Fury,
I give you £1,000.
£1,000.
Yeah.
You sure you want to do this?
Facts.
I'm betting.
Let's shake on it.
All right, cool. You just said on a knockout.
Yeah, knockout.
That's it. If you don't knock him out, then you're done.
Exactly.
All right, cool. Let's bet £1,000.
Shake on it, bruv.
£1,000. If he doesn't knock him out, I want my £1,000.
Yeah, facts. So you get £1,000, bruv. Dunno.
He's not gonna knock him out.
He's gonna knock him out, bruv.
Right.
He's gonna knock him out, bruv. Big man ting.
Cool.
£1,000, bruv.
He's not gonna knock him out.
Bruv, big man ting. I guarantee he's gonna knock him out.
You are fucked.
Did you watch the press conference?
You are fucked. You fucked yourself up.
No, I didn't.
I feel sorry for you. Alright, cool.
You're gonna have to sell a million of these pounds.
Doesn't matter.
Just give me my money back, bruv. You're gonna need to be selling this at everywhere, bruv. You're gonna be
up to the Asda. That's
calm.
You're
gonna be the fucking picnics. You're gonna be after walking up to people in Hyde Park, trying to buy and sell this to people, bruv. You're gonna have to do this everywhere, bruv.
It's cool.
Yeah, I mean, you're going to actually have to set up OnlyFans, bruv, to it's sell calm. Some shit on there, bruv, to get me my money, bruv.
Don't worry, bro. Remember what you said. Thing. You said that. No knockout, you're done.
Big man thing. £1,000, bruv.
It's calm.
Unless you do how much shit that I can buy with that £1,000 that you're going to give me, bruv.
All right, cool.
It's easy money, bruv. Easy money.
Cool. I can't wait. When's the fight again?
July the 19th or July the 20th, sorry? 24th. That's when the fight's going to be.
Say
Big
no
man
more.
Ting, yeah, see that? We're doing a bet, bruv, and it's filmed, bruv. It was filmed, so that's how we did it, bruv. Big man ting. Yeah, we ain't got no more calls, bruv. So is that the end of the show, bruv? Big man ting, they saying talk more about boxing, bruv. These people don't give a fuck about boxing, bruv.
Nah, my money's on the line. I ain't talking about no
money
more
on the
boxing.
Line, bruv. So big man ting, we just made
all
that
I
bet,
know,
bruv.
Yeah.
Jay Gang's gonna give me a grand when Wilder knocks out Fury, bruv.
He's
Big
not
man
gonna
ting.
Knock him out. He's not. No way.
Yeah? So you lot, lock into the Friday night round next week, bruv. We're going to be live, bruv. Big man ting, 9 o'clock. Snap out now. 50K stream, bruv.